Thank you for answering the social relationship section of this interview. Now, for the last section, please answer the questions as truthfully and as quickly as possible. Thank you for your willingness to work for RAMA Industries. We are now processing your PAT4C2 answers. While we evaluate the answers, please take a look at the benefits and terms of agreement on your right and left. We have found a position matching your profile by
87%.
Please, have a pleasant assignment with RAMA Industries. Press the red button to accept the terms and conditions and begin working.
Saturn HQ, you have your first task as the new technician of Base M. We have lost our communication link with the base. Re-establish the comm link between HQ and the comm station. When this is done, we will send further instructions. HQ out.
There's not much we can do. We won't be here anymore. Do you think that... Why is the comlink to HQ back on?
Did I undo that already?
Can't be. I just saw him heading to the generator. Bloody hell. Phil, they didn't listen. They sent someone.
Goddamn RAMA executives.
You there, in the comm station. I am the operating director here, Amanda Pohl. Listen, there is no time to explain, but all the mission data is being loaded in the cargo train.
This is Saturn HQ. Good, we have the comm link up. Thank you. Next, you should head to Base M. On your way there, you could lower the weather station telescope to protect it from the storm. HQ out.
Data barrel, and we're done.
Copy that, Amy. I found the generator's control rod automation. I'll bypass it now.
Station next.
Ion, didn't you hear? RAMA RAMA sent a replacement and the comm link is already up. They didn't listen to us.
What? I better hurry then.
Months now, maybe almost a year. Today I broke out of the airlock. I took the jackhammer, removed the outer door, and I don't know what to make of this. I know this is connected to the thing in the cave. The entity. After all the time I've been here, the things I've seen. I tried to keep Amy's research work going on here. Even with the lack of light, the plants seem to be doing fine. But the bees are behaving strangely. They seem to spread some kind of luminescent dust. Now, they are keeping out of reach, so I haven't been able to catch one to examine, but I'll keep trying. This is some kind of experiment. I wouldn't mind it ending soon and the rescue team coming through the airlock. Feels like a month when you're alone in the dark. This is Karen Kowalski. I am a technician here in Research Base M. I don't know how, but it looks like everyone has disappeared. I was building the platform below the lab and then... well... most of the power is off. Communications are out. And the airlock door is stuck. At least the oxygen level seems stable. So if you're listening to this, come and find me. I found our doctor's lighter in the study. Along with the limited power I've been able to generate from the exercise bike and... well, let there be light, as they say. I brought up some fertilizer from the cargo, but that hasn't really perked up the plants at all. I guess I'm not the only one missing sunlight around here. tried to keep Amy's research work going on here. Even with the lack of light, the plants seem to be doing fine. But the bees are behaving strangely. They seem to spread some kind of luminescent dust. Well, they are keeping out of reach, so I haven't been able to catch one to examine, but I'll keep trying. If this is some kind of experiment, I wouldn't mind it ending soon and the rescue team coming through the airlock. A week feels like a month when you're alone in the dark. Oh, fuck it. I'm holding on to whatever keeps me close to sane. Yeah, Karen. Don't give it up just yet. I'm so tired of hoping for any goddamn thing anymore. I'm tired of this loop. I'm tired of calling it life. Oh, it's getting quite stifling in here. I'm thinking about moving into the lab and stop avoiding the thing in there. The atmosphere there feels somehow lighter. Yeah, it's Karen. Nothing in the base changes. My hair and fingernails were not growing. I think time was standing still. I dream about Ethan and Jessica every night. Even the drugs don't numb the dreams anymore. Yet I keep taking them. In some of the dreams, I'm back at home. But they act like I'm dead. Not hearing anything I say and just looking right through me. I keep telling myself they're only nightmares. I'm alive. I know I'm alive. Patrick is dead, but I am alive. I want him to have a face again. I began recording these messages for the researchers, but I guess I'm doing this for myself now. I only found a couple of cassettes, so I had to tape over the old ones. I think this one is going through its 6th re-recording already. The boredom's really been getting to me. Out of desperation, I've decided to break into the study library. I had to manually override the door system. You know, things are getting bad when you're resorting to breaking and entering just to read some of Philip's literary classics. By the time I get out of here, I'll probably be the most sophisticated RAMA technician in the solar system. Hi, kids. This is Mom. I'm sending you this audio tape so you can hear my voice. My days here on Titan are based on routines. Every day I go and check certain places in the base for broken things. If something is broken, I fix it. Sometimes I have to build something new. Like tomorrow, I'm going to build an extension to a platform in a very deep cave. Wow. That place is something I can't even explain. I wish I could show it to you. In my free time, I go to the gym to run on a treadmill. Oh, and I also read a lot of books. I think reading makes you smarter. So don't you ever stop reading. All right, now I have to go. We have a daily meeting with the others. I miss you and I love you very much. Bye. Today I was really busy at work. Some hoses in the hydro needed urgent fixing. That made me forget about people at home for a while. It almost scared me. I don't want to forget them. I'm here for them. And even if I need to focus on my tasks, I want to remember why I'm doing this. I also wonder where Vasily finds these therapeutic methods. Drawing, talking to yourself on a tape, disco cycling. What's next? Running naked outside?
Thank you. Hangovers in space are not as bad as on Earth. The way things escalated yesterday was really, really weird. I thought I knew these people, but something made them completely lose control. This is well in line with Seifer's findings. Taping one's thoughts and listening to them by oneself could externalize the troubles, making them easier to handle. Testing the personal dialogue therapy. Today, I've not felt guilt from surviving the Europa incident. There are days when I can accept the fact that I couldn't do anything else. But then the pressure of publicity pushes me back into anxiety. I hoped I could just stay away from people, so I could forgive myself. Constructing a timeline of the unusual behavior of the people here since the piece of the entity was brought into the lab, I've come to a conclusion. The MRI scans and measurements of common hormone levels all indicate that everyone here is experiencing the same condition. Homesickness. The entity is affecting our brains, which leads to changes in our moods and desires. Everything's amplified after we brought the sample here. And the people that have been closest to it have experienced the most severe effects. Symptoms that were initially weak and varying have now coalesced and strengthened into severe homesickness. I think we need to get rid of the entity. I have studied the gravity beam, and I am fairly certain I can use it to destroy the sample.
I am a technician here in Research Base M. I don't know how, but it looks like everyone has disappeared. I was building the platform below the lab and then... tried to keep Amy's research work going on here. Even with the lack of light, the plants seem to be doing fine. But the bees are behaving strangely. They seem to spread some kind of luminescent dust. Well, they are keeping out of reach, so I haven't been able to catch one to examine, but I'll keep trying. If this is some kind of experiment, I wouldn't mind it ending soon and the rescue team coming through the airlock. A week feels like a month when you're alone in the dark. house. I don't even get hungry anymore. I stopped eating weeks ago. Nothing happened. I can't get out of here. I can't see my kids. I just want to go home. I have grown tired of this void. In time, and in my mind. I don't know what to do. And my heart has ceased to tell me anything anymore. It just hurts like hell. I think this is hell. I envy those who end up in hell with other people. I have taken the elevator all the way down. I've backed out so many times. This time, I will go all the way. I have gazed into the abyss long enough now. I'm going down there. I'm going to confront the cause of this all. I'm going home.
Amanda Pohl, employee number 02065094F, location Titan, base M. The number of bees and their productivity has experienced a lower level of growth than the growth curve of the plants would suggest. Also, the amount of honey produced does not correlate to the amount of pollen of the flowers. I suspect a rogue queen has made another hive somewhere. This could explain why the number of bees and honey production is lower than the growth curve predicts.
You came.
waited so long. We'll work this out together.
We can finally go home.